Hi friends, in this video you will learn how to write a Verilog code and do simulations in Vivado. So first open the Vivado. I have a Vivado version 2017.4. Now latest version is available. You can download it from the Xylene website. For a student version it is free for a 30-day trial. So you can download it from there. If you want to get a link of download, so please do comment. After opening the Vivado, you have to click on the create project, or from here go to the file and create new project. Okay, so anywhere click on next, write the project name. So here I will show you for hop header and give the location. I have already given it place. Press next and then next, and then select the targeted language Verilog. If you want to do simulation VHDL, you can do it. Click on next. So select the board. So generally we have the Z board, so click on next. Now you have to open the text editor, Verilog editor. So for that you have to click here, add sources, then check mark, add or create design sources, next, then create a file. So the file name is going to be hop header. Okay, next, finish. So these are the, you can first declare input output port declaration. So you can declare here also, and you can also declare at the text editor. So click OK. Yes. So here hop header module is created. So double click on this. In design sources you will get hop header .v Verilog file. So you will get a module and the module name which you have given. Okay, so from here you have to write the Verilog code. So in the hop header we have a two input, let's give A and B, and the output is sum, and then carry. So next, declare the port, that is input port are A and B, output port is sum and carry. So using assign statement, I am going to give the function assign, that is sum is equal to, for hop header the sum is given by XOR of A and B, A XOR B, and then carry is given by A and B. Done. So Verilog code is done. So save here. And this, there is no error is showing here. So next step is to write a test bench code, or you can also simulate it by giving input. So the best way is to write a test bench, because it will help you directly. There is no need to give the input. So for writing the test bench, just add sources and add create simulation sources, next, give the name. I'm giving at last hop header TB, so you can, it will be easy to see that it is a test bench code. Done. Okay, So here you will see in simulation sources there is one. Now here it is half adder test bench. So double click here, open it, and then write the test bench. So for test bench, we are giving the test bench is nothing but it generates the stimulus to the module, and the module gives the output. So the modules, the test bench will give the input of A and B. So that will change. So I am giving a raise TA TB. So these are the, and the buyer is given as saying so sum plus carry. Okay, done. Now I am going to instantiate the module, and this is module name halfadder.b. So I am going to instantiate it. So half adder, then design under test, and I am going to instantiate the port. So the I am going to connect the port of a module and to the test bench. So module having the input port A and B. So A will be connected to test bench of A. Okay, done. Then comma, and then B of module half adder will be connected to TB of test bench, and then some output of module will be connected to sum of test bench, and then carry of module will be connected to the carry of test bench. Now initial begin, okay, when you will get some error, then there will be highlight of red mark. See, initial begin, and that will be end. Okay, so I'm giving the 0. These are the test bench input input stimulus. These are TA and TB are the stimulus which will change. That is why at the time, that is why we have given here raise. And after 10 nanosecond, we are going to change this TA and TB value. So for that, we are going to declare give hash 10. And for two input there is four combination, so I'm going to give it four combination. So first is 00, and then it is will be 01, and then it will be 10, and then it will be 11. It is not mandatory that you will give in serial wise. Okay, and after that we are going to stop. So this is, and there is not any error. Save it here. Done. So what you have to do now here, run simulation. Yeah, got it. So after 10, 10, 10, and 14 nanosecond, our simulation is going to be stopped. So here it has a stop. So we want to view the simulation on the waveform, so we can see it here. So see, from 0 to 10 nanosecond, what is TA and TB are 0, 0. So sum is also 0, carry is also 0. So again after 10 nanosecond, the TA is 0 and 1 TB. So sum will be 1 and carry will be 0. So after 20 nanosecond, TA is 1, TB is 0. So sum will be 1 and carry will be 0. And then after that, TA is 1 and TB is 1. Both are 1. So sum will be 0 and carry will be 1. And after 40 nanosecond, we are going to stop the simulation here. Done. So this is simulation. Now if you want to view the schematic, so here go RTL analysis, open, and here this is schematic. So open it. So this is the schematic of half adder. So in half adder, it is a sum is given by XOR and carry is given by this is AND gate. And then you can also run the synthesis, and then after that you can run the implementation. And then after that, if you have a FPGA board and if you want to verify the functionality on the FPGA board, then you can generate the beta stream and then you can follow the steps. Okay, so this is basics you can learn. So guys, thanks for watching and please do subscribe my channel.